You can appreciate the Lord with a hand clap of praise. Appreciate the Lord. Worship Him. Thank you. Thank you. God bless you. We may have our seats. Tunaweza kuketi katika huo uwepo wa Bwana. I want us to turn to the book of James. I'll be sharing from the book of James. Actually, my sharing today is drawn majorly from the book of James, and the title of my message is Faith Lessons. Faith Lessons from the book of James. Faith Lessons from the book of James. Our Father Apostle last Sunday shared about faith. Na nikawa kitabu ya Yakobo ndicho nimekuwa nikisoma kwa wakati huu. And when I was preparing to come and minister, I was so much inclined, I was so much led to sharing from the book of James. Amen? So if you didn't get my title, I want to repeat it again. It is Faith Lessons from the book of James. They want us to read from James chapter 1. I'll be reading other verses, and I'll be quoting other verses from the book of James and other scriptures. But I want us to read from the book of James, chapter 1. We are reading from verse 1 through to verse 12. No, through to verse 15. So do you have your Bible? Oh, you already have it on the screen. Na maana nikikuambia usome Bible yako, kuna mwenye yako na ESV, kuna mwenye yako na ya Kikamba, ya Kiswahili, na ya Kikamba ni mzuri sana, by the way. Ya Kikuyu, for the sake of uniformity, then you can check your Bible. Let's read from the screen. Please read with me. To go. Let's continue. Count it all joy. Because you know that the testing of your faith develops perseverance. Perseverance must finish its work so that you may be mature and complete, not lacking anything. If any of you lacks wisdom, he should ask God, who gives generously to all without finding fault, and it will be given to him. Maybe we get up to that point. Then we can go to James chapter 2. James chapter 2 and verse 26 only. James chapter 2 and verse 26 only. You can read it with me. As the body without the spirit is dead, so faith without deeds is dead. And may the Lord bless the reading of his word. Amen. Praise the Lord. Amen. We know very well that the book of James was written by James, who was the half-brother to Christ. Alikuwa ndugu wa Yesu, lakini ni the other son, one of the other sons of Mary and Joseph. We have their names, and the other one actually it is Jude, the book of Jude. But amazingly, when James is introducing himself, he says, James, a servant of God and of the Lord Jesus Christ. James, a servant of God and of the Lord Jesus Christ. Nataka kukuuliza leo, kama ingekuwa ni wewe ambaye ulipata nafasi ya kushare mama mmoja na Yesu na upata nafasi ya kuandika hii barua, ungeanzia aje? Ungeanzia aje? Pengine ungeandika useme, Getau, ndugu mdogo wa Yesu wa Nazareti. Ama mtoto wa pili wa Mary and Joseph. You'd want people to know ya kwamba wewe sio mtu mdogo. You'd want people to know that you are indeed close to Jesus. Yeah? Praise the Lord. But James communicates a very rare Christian virtue, a very important Christian virtue, that of humility, that he would say, James, a servant of God and a servant of Jesus Christ. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Na wapendwa, ni vizuri maandiko huwa inatuambia, hata James mwenyewe aliandika katika 4 verse 6, James 4 verse 6, he says, God opposes the proud but gives grace to the humble. God opposes the proud but he gives grace to the humble. It is good for you and me to always embrace humility and practice humility in our lives. Bwana sifiwe. Ya kwamba hata huyu mtumishi alipokuwa akianza kuandika hii barua, hakuona kutoka familia moja na Yesu kama ni kitu ya kuandika, lakini alijiita mtumishi, a servant of Jesus Christ. Other translations actually say a bond servant. Ni yule mtumishi ama mfanyikazi ambaye hawezi akatoka kwa ile jamii, maana amenunuliwa na hawezi kombolewa. A bond servant. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. So regardless of your high position in society, regardless of which family you come from, of course, if somebody was preaching here and you hear our speaker today, it is so and so Kenyatta, you may want to change your attitude toward that fellow. Sema, wacha nisikia huyu mhubiri ametoka kwa first family. Akona ujumbe mgani, bwana sifiwe. Regardless of where you come from, regardless of your position in the society, we are called upon to embrace the virtue of humility. As James would later write in chapter 4 and verse 6b, that God opposes the proud, but he gives grace to the humble. Praise the Lord. Faith lessons from the book of James. Faith lessons from the book of James. And lesson number one that I have come across from this book of James, which actually has 5 chapters only, I want to encourage you to go through it. It's a very short book, but with very practical lessons on Christian living. Ni kitabu kifupi tu, lakini kimejaa utajiri. Praise the Lord. Lesson number one, anaelekea kuwapatia kitu inaitwa judgment. And so he ran away. It was even his prayer that God will punish Nineveh. And that's why he was offended. Wakati Mungu alihurumia wao watu. Maana walikuwa wamesumbua Israeli kabisa. Mtu wamekusumbua, alafu Mungu wamsamehe just like that. Bwana sifiwe. Your faith will be tested. It is not a question of if, it is a question of when. If Jesus was tested, if Jesus went through trials, I pray for you in Jesus' name, that in the day of testing, that there will be grace for you. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. So the Israelites were tested, the patriarchs were tested, that is, Abraham was tested. And we can learn that God allows trials and testing to come so that he may humble you and he may also know what is in your heart, why you follow him, why you say you are born again. Amen? Praise the Lord. James chapter 1 and verse 12. James chapter 1 and verse 12. Look at what the word of God says. James chapter 1 and verse 12. You can read it to your neighbor because it's an encouragement to him or to her. You can read together. Blessed is the man who endures temptations, for when he has been approved, he will receive the crown of life which the Lord has promised to those who love him. There is a crown. Amen? There is a crown for those who overcome. For those who endure trials and temptations. Praise the Lord. But I also want us to learn that the flesh and the devil tempt our faith. Amen? We know the story of Joseph. We know he was working in the house of Potiphar. And we know what Mrs. Potiphar wanted to do. And the young man ran away. He was only 17 years. Praise the Lord. And James says here in James chapter 1 and verse 13, that God tempts no one. God tempts no one. No one should say God is tempting me, for God cannot be tempted by evil, nor does he tempt anyone. And you study, when you look at Luke chapter 4, you see it is the devil. It is the devil who was tempting Jesus in the wilderness. Praise the Lord. And I'm telling you, the devil will also want to come and tempt you. Na ulimwengu huu tunaishi, umejaa uovu sana. Na sasa majaribu inakuwa mengi. Majaribu yuko kwa TV, majaribu yuko kwa simu, majaribu yuko kwa matatu, katika mavazi, majaribu iko kila mahali. Sasa Bwana atusaidie. Bwana asifiwe. The word of God says in James chapter 1 and verse 14, it is our desires. It is our desires. Eh? Unatamani kitu, na hiyo kitu sio mzuri. Halafu juu ya hiyo tamaa inakuelekeza kwa dhambi. Na sasa nayo dhambi ikikolea, maandiko inasema kifo inapatikana. Praise the Lord. One thing leads to the other. And brothers, I've come from a family that struggled with alcohol, with alcoholism. And I know what alcohol can do. I know what alcohol can do. Hata kama unaonanga mahali pale kwa televisheni ikiwa advertised vizuri sana, ni kama wenye wanaikunywa wanasikia vizuri sana. Eh? Na wao ni wanaume sana. Eh? Let me tell you. Hata ikipigiwa campaign inatoshana aje. Please stay away from it. I'm saying this because even Christian men are being lured by the groups of men to partake or to take part in what we call traditional rituals. Inaweza kuwa ni ya ndoa, ni ya mahali imeletwa. Inaweza kuwa ni aina nyingine, ni sherehe fulani ya ukikuyu inafanyika. Na sasa hapo inakuwa pombe inahusika kama one of the component ya hiyo sherehe. Ili ikamilike. Huo ni ukikuyu, lakini sasa kuko na Ukristo. Bwana asifiwe. Na lazima ujue wewe utajiidentify kama mukikuyu ama kama Mukristo. Hallelujah. Siku hizi watu wanasema mimi ni Mukristo mukikuyu. Kwa hivyo, ukiona ninafanya chenye nafanya ujue, mimi ni Mukristo? Sio Mukikuyu, Mukristo. And there is a whole lot of difference in those two statements. Praise the Lord. Because that temptation, leo utaitwa uende, ukae hapo, meza imejaa, pilsina, na wewe unapewa soda. Maana wanajua umeokoka. Hiyo mkutano ingine utaitwa. Upewe ile Malta Guinness. Maana si pombe sana. Hiyo siku nyingine utasema kama ndugu mwingine. Ambaye najua. Katika hiyo pilika pilika alisema, ne gonywa. Pasta hata kiri haa. As in, mchungaji hako hapa. Sasa nitaka hapa na wanaume, wanaenjoy maisha hivi na mimi hapa nakunywa soda. Kama mwanamke. Akakunywa. Lakini ilikuwa, by and by, it was a process of recruitment. And before he could know it. Praise the Lord. Brothers and sisters, the devil will come. And he will wrap the temptation. Atarap hiyo kitu vizuri. Hata wewe ukiangalia unaitamani. Bwana asifiwe. Lakini nakuambia na kushauri. Hata ikikuja na ile karatasi ya kufunga mazawadi. Just say no in Jesus' name. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Because the word of God in Ephesians chapter 4 and verse 17 tells us to put off the old self. To put off the old self. Na ile mambo huyo mtu wakale huwa anatamani. Sasa uwezi ikawa Mungu amekukomboa utoke kwa kukunywa pombe. Wewe ulikuwa una struggle na pombe. Lakini wewe fellowship yako ni ya wale watu wanakunywanga pombe. Utarudi nyuma. Bwana asifiwe. Hata kama ni chai unakunywa usikunywa kwa club. Maana, that is a wrong environment for somebody like you. Amen. Usikubali kupelekwa mikutano mahali pabaya. Acha niachie hapo hiyo. Praise the Lord. The only time we are happy about tests or trials is when we know we are prepared for them and we are anxious for the new level. This is the other side of trials, is that they put you to the next level. When you have overcome, you go to the next level. For Joseph, he went to prison and from prison to palace. For Jesus, the scripture says that he endured the cross and scorned its shame because of the glory that was set before him. And so the scriptures do tell us in Hebrews 12, that we fix our eyes on him. Maana jinsi alivyovumilia msalaba na akavumilia ile aibu, akaibisha aibu, basi na wewe ukaweze kuvumilia. Maana after kuvumilia, there is a reward for you. Praise the Lord. Lesson two from the faith lesson from the book of James. Lesson two is that faith must be accompanied by actions. Faith must be accompanied by actions. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. The challenge we have in our world today, and specifically in Kenya, is that we have so many confessing believers, but very few practicing believers. So many confessing believers, but very few practicing believers. Siku moja nilikuwa pale Katoloni, nilikuwa tumeenda maombi na vijana. I was the youth chairman then. And we had gone there to pray, and somebody rose to give a testimony. It was around after the post-election violence, actually. Na huyo dada akawa anaongea na uchungu sana. Akisema, mume wangu aliuawa na watu tulikuwa kanisa moja na wao. And we couldn't believe it. That I know the people. They actually came and told her, wewe ni wetu, wewe na watoto ondokeni hapa. Musione ile maneno inafanyika mahali hapa. Wanasifiwe. So many confessing believers, but very few practicing believers. If you would only practice your faith, then you'd see how different our world will be. Hallelujah. If you'd practice your faith in giving, in being a faithful giver, I'm telling you, this church only could feed all the hungry people in this town. Hata inaweza julikana, ukiwa na njaa enda redeemed. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Siangalia mtu mwambie, situjaribu hiyo. Bwana asifiwe. If you'd practice your faith, you'd see even hiyo plot yenu vyenye mambo inaweza badilika. Amen. If we'd only practice our faith, we'd see how our town would change. Sasa, James alipeana mifano hapo ambayo ukijisikia umetajwa, ujue ni maandiko sio mimi. Maandiko inasema, chapter 2 and verse 14, what good is it, my brothers, if someone says he has faith but does not have works? Can that faith save him? If a brother or sister is poorly clothed and lacking in daily food, and one of you says to them, one of you, it's not my words, it's the Bible, go in peace and be warmed and filled. Enda usikie joto na ushibe. Nitakuombea. Mpendwa, hata wacha tuombee hilo jambo. James is saying, without giving them the things needed for their body, what good is that? So also faith by itself, if it does not have works, it is dead. Mutu ambaye ako na njaa, usimuombe. Patia chakula. Hallelujah. Na hizo amen, hazinitii moyo. Ninarudia nasema, mutu ambaye ako na njaa, akikuja kwako usimuombe. Mpe chakula, halafu maombi ikuje baadaye. Hallelujah. Mtu akikuja kwako akwambie, mpendwa, mtoto wangu anarudi shule. Na kusema ukweli sina kakitu. Usimwambie leta mkono, leta mkono tuamini Bwana. Ni sawa muamini Bwana, lakini rudi kwa mfuko. Hata kama utampatia 500 na inahitajika 20,000, atachua ya kwamba kuna mtu ambaye amesimama na yeye. Praise the Lord. And that is what James is saying. And most of the time, our problem is not knowing what we are supposed to do. Our problem most of the time, it is doing what we are supposed to do. Bwana asifiwe. Hallelujah. Angalia mtu umwambie tutie bidii. Amen. Before you tell people you are born again, let them see it in your actions. Before you try to convince them, ninakuanga nimeokoka. Wacha kwanza waione kwa macho. Waone huo wokovu. Wacha wakuulize, kwani dada unakuanga umeokoka? See, the other way round. Ya kwamba unaweza sema, mimi, ukicheza na mimi, naweza weka Yesu chini. Ujue mimi ni nani. Na ili ujue kuokoka si ujinga. So you want to justify your carnality. Praise the Lord. James says, if your faith is not accompanied by such actions, then it is dead. Achana nayo, haifanyi kazi, na hatuihitaji. Kwa hivyo kama umeokoka, matendo yako iwe, imeokoka. Ya mtu ameokoka. Hallelujah. Sasa imani zinapungua, ni kama ni ishara ni niende pole pole hapo. Lakini nasema kwa jina la Yesu, kama umeokoka, matendo yako ikae ya mtu ambaye ameokoka. Amen. Wendi utafanya majirani wakuje kanisani. Wamuamini Yesu. Wewe ndiye utafanya yule mtu ambaye mnafanya kazi na yeye amuamini Yesu. By the way, hata wokovu wa watoto wako, in a great way, utachangiwa na venye unaishi imani yako, how you practice your faith. In a way. Kuna yule ambaye anaweza potea, lakini kuna watoto najua wako. Actually, mmoja alikiri. Alikiri, mimi niliokoka kwa sababu ya baba yangu. Sasa, usiwe pale nyumbani mzee, unawaka moto. Usiwe pale nyumbani mama. Your husband is a nobody. You can say anything to him or even to your children. Alafu unasema tuombe watoto wetu waokoke. Sasa hiyo ni kizungumkuti. Bwana asifiwe. Praise the Lord. We should be ready to have our faith accompanied by acts of righteousness. Imagine somebody by the name Rahab. Now, amazingly, maandiko ina kila mahali Rahab anatajwa, hatajwi na jina mzuri, lakini ameendelea kutokea katika maandiko in different sections of the Bible because of what she did. Ya kwamba alisikia wale watu wa Mungu wanakuja kuteka mji wetu na akawa ameamini ni ukweli. So when the spies came, she treated them on account of the faith she had on what God had done for the Israelites. Amen? And she is in the Bible because of her actions, her faith in God. Amen? We should be ready to give to the needy. It is our responsibility. Amen. We should be ready to take bold steps of faith. Like Abraham, we should be willing to move beyond our comfort so that we may practice our faith. Amen. And lesson number three, as I come to the conclusion of my message. Lesson number three. Lakini pia kuna jambo moja ambalo nilikuwa nimeruka hapo. Our actions, ambazo James anasema hazifai, anasema ni zile za ubaguzi, partiality. That is in James chapter 2 and verse 1. Chapter 2 and verse 1. My brothers, show no partiality as you hold the faith in our Lord Jesus Christ, the Lord of glory. Hata hapa kanisani, maandiko inakuja kwetu, inatuambia ya kwamba we should show no partiality. Amen? Na James ameelezea hapo. Eh? Mtu ambaye ako na kakitu akikuja, na ni wewe uko in charge, na mwingine hana kakitu akikuja, sasa utapata yule ambaye hana kakitu, anaambiwa wewe goja hapo kidogo nimalizane na mkubwa. Sasa James anasema, hiyo ni ubaguzi na haifai. Praise the Lord. Lesson number three. Faith has great outcomes. Faith has great outcomes. Amen. Faith is greatly rewarded. Amen. Jesus always commended people for their faith and also rebuked even his disciples for the lack of faith. For their lack of faith. When you look at ukiangalia kitabu cha Mathayo, Matthew 9 and verse 22. But Jesus turned around and when he saw her, he said, "Be of good cheer, daughter, your faith has made you well." And the woman was made well from that hour. Amen. Mark 5 and verse 34. Mark 5 and verse 34. Mark 5 and verse 34. And he said to her, "Daughter, your faith has made you well. Go in peace and be healed in your affliction." The same person, the same outcome. Praise the Lord. Your faith will be rewarded. Can you help me preach it to your neighbor? Praise the Lord. Kuna mahali huwa unafaa kufika kama Mkristo. Hata wewe ujiambie kwa imani nitaanza hii kitu. Kwa imani nitaanza. Because Hebrews 11 verse 6 tells us that without faith, it is impossible to please God. You don't always want to wait for the right time. Na goja, una postpone kesho, una postpone hiyo siku nyingine kulinyesha, hiyo siku nyingine, only because you have fear of starting. Is it a business idea? Go and start by faith. Wacha kukuzia watu nyanya na huuzi. Unawauzia kwa maneno tu. Na mahali kule nimetoka, huwa tunasema, bare ya geka. Nasemanga, gojeni mutaona. Gojeni mutaona. Nitajenga. Nitaoa. Nitaanza biashara. Go and start. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Go and start. Go and do it by faith in Jesus' mighty name. I want us to look at another scripture in the book of Luke, chapter 8 and verse 25. Luke chapter 8 and verse 25. These are the disciples of Jesus Christ. They were with him in the boat. We can start from verse 24. And they came to him and awoke him, saying, Master, Master, we are perishing. Then he arose and rebuked the wind and the raging of the water, and they ceased, and there was a calm. Verse 25. But he said to them, Where is your faith? Where is your faith? And they were afraid and marveled, saying to one another, Who can this be? For he commands even the winds and water, and they obey him. Imagine, Jesus expected his disciples to calm the sea. He expected them to speak to the sea, venye alifanya na iweze kutulia. Waambie bahari, mtulie, waambie upepo, mtulie, na itulie. And every time I read this text, it's like, well, it's like, Yesu alikuwa anauliza, kwa nini munaniamsha? Eh? Kwa nini munaniamsha? And those of us who are married, you know your wife can wake you up to ukuje, ufukuze, najua najaribu kuitaja pole pole. Ufukuze kapanya ama kamende. Eh? Na unapata hata watoto wamekanyanga meza. Kila mtu wako juu ya meza. Kuko na panya kwa hii nyumba. Eh? Sasa unakuja hapo unauliza, Where? Where is your faith? Yani mende inakuhangaisha kwako. Karibu utoroke nje, uache panya ishi kwako. Bwana asifiwe. That Jesus would consider such an occasion, hiyo upepo na hizo mawimbi, kuwa kitu kidogo sana ya kwamba hawakufaa kumuamsha, walifaa kuongea na upepo na uwasikie. Praise the Lord. Look at your neighbor and ask them, Where is your faith? Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. You need to remember that your faith will be tested. It is not a question of if, but a question of when. Praise the Lord. And 1 Corinthians 10 and verse 13 says that God will make a way for you. When you are tested, when you are tempted, God will make a way for you. God will make a way for you. Brothers and sisters, let us remember that anything that we consume, even the water that is on the table, it must go through a quality test. Bwana sifiwe. Na hata wokovu wako, lazima upitie hiyo. The quality test. Kama ni wokovu vugu vugu, ama ni wokovu halisi. Amen. Your faith will be rewarded. Amen. Faith has great outcomes. Faith has great outcomes. It has great outcomes. Na mimi watu wa biashara huwa wananifunza imani sana. Ya kwamba unaweza enda kwa banku chukue pesa. Na hakuna mtu amekuambia atakuja kununua kwa duka yako. Wewe umeona, oh, hii area hakuna hoteli mzuri. Unaenda kwa bank, unachukua loan. Na hata unaambia mtu nisainie hapa, na mwingine nisainie hapa. Unachukua loan, na unafungua hoteli. Maana unaamini Mungu atabariki kazi ya mkono yako, na pia ataleta wateja. You do it by faith. Praise the Lord. Faith has great outcomes. You need to exercise your faith. Praise the Lord. And faith must be accompanied with actions, because faith without actions, faith without action is hallelujah. We can stand up on our feet. I want you to just lift up your voice before the Lord. I don't know what you have learned from this sharing. Maybe you are the one who is being tested. You are in the middle of that test, that difficult test, and you don't know. In fact, you even don't know what you are going to do after this service. You don't know what you'll tell your landlord after this service. Mana tapiga simu. Leo ni tarehe 12. Bwana asifiwe. Maybe you are going through that test and you don't know what you are going to do. Just trust in God. Amen? Trust in God. Trust in God. He will make a way for you. Maybe you are going through another type of a test. Your children. It's true you love the Lord, but they have gone the wrong way. Trust in God. Praise the Lord. They are in the hands of God. And God will bring them around in Jesus' name. Maybe it is your business that is not working. Your place of work, you are facing difficulties. Just have faith in God. Praise the Lord. I want you for a moment, you just tell God to help you, that you will have faith in Him. Despite the situation that you could be in, you will still have faith in God in the mighty name of Jesus. Lift up your voice before the Lord in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Father, we ask in the name of Jesus that you may help our unbelief where our faith is going down. Lord, we ask in the name of Jesus, increase our faith. Just like the disciples, we ask, oh Lord, increase our faith. Increase our faith, oh Lord. Increase our faith in you, in the mighty name of Jesus, that we may be able to stand strong in the mighty name of Jesus. Oh God, we ask that you may increase our faith in the mighty name of Jesus. In the mighty name of Jesus. Those who are going through difficult situations, those whose faith is being tested, dear Lord, I pray for your grace upon them. I pray in the name of Jesus that they will come out victorious in the name of the Lord. Father, I pray in the name of Jesus that they will go to the next level because your grace will work in their lives, even in this period of trials and temptation, dear Father. We honor you, dear Lord, for you have called us to be the salt of the world. You are calling us to practice our faith. Bwana, tunaomba kwa jina la Yesu. Mahali tumekuwa na woga, wakutenda matendo ya imani, ukatusaidia katika jina la Yesu. Help us to minister even to the needs of other people, that we may practice our faith the way you want us to do, in the mighty name of Jesus. I pray, King of all glory, those who have taken bold steps of faith, the Lord, they be rewarded in the mighty name of Jesus. My Father and my God, there are those who have started businesses. May you consider their faith. May you consider their faith in the name of Jesus, that you may sustain them in the mighty name of Jesus. Bwana, kuna wale wamechukua hatua, hata wametoa sadaka za imani. Sadaka ambazo ni sacrifice mbele zako Bwana. May you consider their faith. May be done unto them according to their faith in you. In the mighty name of Jesus. King of all glory, have your way in our lives, O God, that you may strengthen our faith in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, we thank you and we bless you. May your word bear fruit in our lives as we go out there to practice it. for the glory and for the honor of your holy name. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray and we believe. Amen and amen. Unaweza mpigia Bwana Yesu makofi ya sifa. As you get to have your seats briefly, ninapomleta apostle ili atuambie jinsi tutakavyoweza kuondoka. Niwakumbushe young couples.